Hey guys, I'm Mina Saywhat here at the Radio 103.9 Lounge. I have a special artist who will be performing today. His name is DDG. Yes.
How you doing?
Can you turn my mic up, please? Check one. I don't know what just happened to the mic. Okay, great. So I wanted to make sure my mic is all right because it kind of switched up there.
Yeah.
So how you doing, DDG? How are you today?
I'm good. I'm really good.
Yeah. Can we fix the mics, please? Something's going on with them. So tell me about your name. Like, how'd you get your name?
So my name is actually, it's my initials. So my name is Daryl Dwayne Granberry. So, you know, it's just okay. My initials, DDG.
That's good.
Yes, ma'am.
I thought it was going to be like, you know, you were going to be like, I don't know. I just came
Somebody
up with it.
Somebody told me they thought it meant drop dead gorgeous.
I can see that.
Yeah, I mean, it's cool, though. But, yeah, this is my name.
I noticed that about you. Like, you're a good looking guy here.
Okay.
Do you think that helps you?
I think so. You know, it's good to have good looks, especially on stage and stuff like that, being out in the public, being
right.
A public figure.
Right. Yeah. So we were talking before we started the interview. You actually started doing videos on YouTube.
Yes, ma'am.
And then transitioned into music.
Yep.
So what made you like go on YouTube and start doing stuff?
I just like entertaining, you know, I just like having fun. So it was all about just fun for me. And then it turned into a career very, very fast for me. And I started making money from it. And I always been into music, though. But then once I opened up that door for me to have like a following, to have like an audience, it made it easier for me to go into music.
Right. So you said it became a business, like YouTube came to you and said, hey, we see potential in you. We want you to be a part of, you know, because I know they were doing at one point, they were recruiting people to actually put out content. And then like they were creating basically a platform for people to like, you know, we were talking about TV, how TV's kind of phasing out a little bit. They were really innovative with trying to put people on board to create this content that people wanted. Were you a part of that? Like, how were you getting?
Nah, I was just somebody that just liked to make videos, and YouTube was already, like, popping
right.
At the time when I got on it, you know? So I was just making videos, and then you get monetized.
Yeah.
And then that's when you start making money. And once you make over $100, you get that money. You know what I mean? And, my first check, actually, I was working at TJ Maxx, and my first check was $200, and I quit as soon as I
You quit with $200
check? Yeah. Like, it's crazy, because I'm really just having fun
right.
Doing videos, and I just got paid for it. If I can make $200, that means I can make $10,000, and I can make $100,000 if I keep working.
That's good that you had that oversight.
Yeah.
So what were you making at TJ Maxx at the time?
Probably like $100 to $150 a week.
A week?
Yeah.
And then you made the $200 in how long on YouTube?
It takes a month to get paid.
Okay.
So it was like, it wasn't as smart as it sounds, but it was like, it's like, you know, this is just dope. I can just make money from home.
Right.
You know? And I see the analytics going up. So it was like, it just made sense.
Yeah. So around what time did you decide I'm actually become an artist? And did you have like any musical background prior to that?
Yeah. My dad used to be an engineer. So I used to mess around in our little home studio with my brothers and stuff like that. And then, also, like, I used to battle rap in school, and then I used to do diss tracks on YouTube and stuff like that, and they used to hit millions and millions and millions of views. So I was like, you know, let me go into music.
And I saw one of your little freestyles.
Yeah.
The one, one of them where you were like, something about Trump, I'm in D.C.
And oh, yeah.
I thought that was cute.
Yeah, that was like yesterday or something.
Yeah,
that was,
I saw that.
Really recent. Yeah.
So you do that off the top all the time for fun?
Yeah, I'll just be having fun with it.
Do chilling. Something now. Let me see.
That's crazy. Put me on the spot. I would, but, you know, we kind of live streaming right now.
Right, right. Okay.
Yeah.
Next time.
Yeah.
Next time.
Next time.
So sure. Tell me about your background a little bit. You told me you're from
Pontiac, Michigan.
Pontiac, Michigan. So what do you do in Pontiac, Michigan?
There's not much to do.
You know, I figured.
Yeah, there's not much to do.
What do y'all
you know,
do out there?
Go to the mall, but the mall is not even in the city. You know, the mall is like on the outskirts of the city. So just go to school, go home, play the game.
Yeah, go on YouTube.
Yeah, or you in the streets.
Go on the internet.
Yeah, or you in the streets, you know. So I chose to be in school, and I chose to be in the video games. I chose to be the good kid, you know.
That's great. So you did good in school.
I was valedictorian in school.
Yes, DDG,
yeah.
You get him.
Yes,
okay.
Yes,
he got the face and the brains.
Yeah,
you're a problem.
That's something I'm really proud of.
Yeah, that's great.
That. Yeah, that's a big deal for me.
You know what? It's That's funny you say that, and I'm thinking about something that I read where you said you got like a 20 on your ACTs and you were upset.
Yeah.
Because you wanted a 21.
I literally cried. You know what I mean? Because I was really big on school. Like, that's something that I took very, very serious. Like, I take music serious. That's how I took school serious. So I used to stay after school, like, every day and study. You know what I mean? People used to pay me to do their homework. I was that kid. You know, but I was, like, the best of both worlds. I was the cool kid. You know, I had the girls with me and all this other stuff. But I was also smart at the same time. You know, but the ACT, I took it, like, 4 times. I got a 23 times. Then last time I got a 19. I just said, forget it.
That's good. Some people can't even get a 20. I think I got a 22.
Yeah.
So you did the SATs?
ACT.
Did you do SATs, though?
No,
they only do the ACTs on that on that part of the country.
Yeah, in Michigan, yeah.
Okay. That's good. I like that you're saying that, you know, because some kids don't think school is important, but school is important.
Yeah, I think school is fun. It's competitive to me.
Right.
You know, so
you have kids? What's, like, your personal life like?
Nah, I ain't got no kids.
No kids? Nah, okay. Yeah. How old are you?
Huh? I'm 21.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. Not no kids yet? What does that mean? Is there one on the way?
I like kids, though. Okay. That's the thing. That's dangerous for me, though. I don't need to have none, but I like kids. But I ain't got no kids. I ain't got no babies on the way, nothing like that. But I'm only 21.
Yeah.
I'm just working. My career's shooting off.
Right, right.
I shouldn't have no kids right now.
Right. Just asking, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know. A cute kid like this with some brains, you would think, you know.
Yeah, appreciate the compliments.
So if you weren't rapping, like, what would you be doing? Because you're clearly smart.
Ooh, I don't know, actually. You know, I really set myself to plan A and plan B. Like, one thing that my first dream was to be an actor. You know, I did an independent movie before, and I just didn't like being told what to do. So I kind of, like, fell off from it because I felt like I was just lingering around, and then they was like, go stand over here. All right, say this. I'm like, you know, because right now, like, nobody tells me what to do. I do what I want to do. You know what I mean? And I just feel free, you know?
So you're fairly new at the music, but, like, long term, do you have a plan? Because you just mentioned plan A and plan B, and normally people don't need, like, I have plan A, plan B, plan C. You don't normally have people that even have plans for their lives. They're kind of just winging it and living. So I'm pretty sure you probably have plans for your future.
So my plan A really opened up for a lot of other letters, you know, just being on YouTube and having
you have the alphabet?
Yeah, I got the whole alphabet. Being on YouTube, like, I can branch out to fashion. You know, coming out with, like, clothes. I can branch off to being creating, like, MCN, which is, like, managing other creators and stuff like that, or starting a record label. You know what I mean? Like, I can do so much stuff just because I got this large fan base, you know? So, but, like, you know, rapping and making music and even singing is, like, a passion of mine.
Right. Yeah. Tell me about your outfit, because I can already tell you're very fashionable. You told me you're into turtlenecks now.
Yeah, this is my turtleneck look. Yeah, this is my new thing right now, so I'm rocking all the I got all the turtlenecks in the country right now.
Do you do the you remind me of Trey Songz a little bit, like,
really?
your swag a little bit. Do you do the Trey Songz face? You know how you be like the cute face?
When I'm talking to the ladies, yeah, maybe.
Can I see it?
Nah, I can't do that right now.
You can't show me the face?
I can't do it. You put me on the spot. I'm nervous.
So tell me about your new project, because you dropped the project, EP, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So tell me about it. It's 4 tracks.
Mm-hmm. Sorry for the Hold Up is the name of it.
Mm-hmm.
The reason I named it that is because I got a song on there called Hold Up featuring Queen Naija.
I love it.
Appreciate
it's one
it.
Of my favorite songs on there.
Appreciate it. Yeah, I got a song, and I made that song actually last year, like maybe like 6-7 months ago.
Right.
And I've been teasing it for so long, and then I finally dropped it. So let me call it Sorry for the Hold Up, you know? But yeah, I got a song called Lil Baby on there, which I really, really enjoy.
Uh-huh.
And I got another song called Too Much to Lose. And Run It Up, of course.
Run It Up, yeah. Which is your single.
Yep.
So talk to me about the Queen Naija, because I feel like, you know, I've heard her songs, but I feel like she's like, it's a different vocal tone that I'm hearing in this song. She sounds amazing.
Yeah. I think I brought something out of her.
So you guys were in the studio together?
Yep. Yeah, we was in Atlanta when we made that one.
This was prior when she was pregnant at
she
the time
pregnant
or prior?
At the time. Yeah, she was pregnant at the time. So
it was, that was probably the baby in there singing.
This is actually before people knew that she was pregnant, I think. Yeah, people didn't even know she was pregnant when we made this.
You know what's crazy? I did an interview with her right here, and I had no idea she was pregnant.
Yeah.
Like, zero. And then afterwards, I started doing the math when she announced it, And I'm like, wait, she was pregnant during my interview. Yeah. And so. Clarence was sitting right there. Yeah. And I was asking her about Clarence. And she's like, well, you know, we're not really like announcing what we're doing. And yeah. she was pregnant, you know, during the interview.
Yeah.
So who came up with like the treatment for the song? Did you guys work with a producer or was this all you?
Nah, yeah, we work with a producer. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it all came together just perfectly. And I don't know, man.
You write all your own stuff?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
That's right. How do you feel about ghostwriters?
I mean, you know, it's cool. You know, it's all art. Uh-huh. You know, people ghostwrite for a reason, you know, because they don't want to be in the limelight, but they've got the talent. And then you give it to another talent that's able to produce it, able to project it and make it a hit, you know. So either way, if it hits, then it's some talent in there, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, I'm not against it.
Right. Would you do that for another artist?
Yeah, I would, actually. I think that's dope, you know, because I'm good at writing.
Oh, okay, good.
I'm really good at writing. Yeah.
So Run It Up, you have G Herbo on it, YBN Namir, and Black Youngster, right?
Yep.
And talk to me about their verses, because I have a favorite, the person that I think killed the whole song, besides you, obviously. But who do you think, like, had the best verse on that?
To me personally?
Mm-hmm.
I like Black Youngster.
Me too. Yeah. I was hoping you were gonna say that.
Yeah.
He comes in like a boss. He comes in and the cadence and the flow.
Yeah. I got his first actually, and when I first heard his verse, I was like, "Ooh, that's crazy."
So when you hear someone's verse, you gotta like, do you want to go back and like redo it? Like redo yours?
Sometimes it actually for like the song to hold up, I redid my verse a few times. You know what I mean? But the Black Youngster verse, that was crazy. Because, you know, I don't know him personally. So, like, if you get a verse from another artist that don't really know you, you're expecting something that's not their best.
Right.
But that was, like, fire. And I was like, oh, that's lit.
Yeah. Why wasn't he wasn't in the video, right?
He's in the music video, but he wasn't there. I think he was, like, in Amsterdam or something like that.
Oh, getting it popping.
Yeah.
Amsterdam. Yeah,
he's doing his thing out there.
You had a project, an older project called Take Me Serious, which I thought was an interesting, like, title to name something.
Yeah.
Where did that come from?
Just because, coming off of YouTube, a lot of people don't take you serious. They're like, oh, he's just a YouTuber. He's a YouTube rapper or whatever. And, I just wanted people to take me serious, you know, because a lot of people was like, why is he on, like, even XXL, like, I got the most views on my pitch, like, out of every artist that did a XXL pitch, mine was trending, and he got the most views, and people will still call me, like, a YouTube rapper. I'm like, at some point, you know, you got to give me my credit, you know?
Why do you think that is? Because every new artist that I talk to, literally, their come up is from YouTube. Like or social media.
Yeah.
But why do you think people are still not respecting that avenue for music?
Honestly, I don't know. I really just feel like it's some hating stuff, to be honest, you know, because it's like people come from all different types of platforms. Like Ariana Grande come from, what, Nickelodeon? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You got Selena Gomez coming from Disney Channel.
Right, right.
Drake coming from Degrassi. You know what I mean? You got all these big artists that came off of a separate platform. And, you know, I guess you just got to break that barrier.
That was good.
Yeah,
once you I didn't even stack it up like that. Yeah. Wait a minute.
Once you break
that boy's right.
Yeah, once you break that barrier, then it's like people forget about that. You know?
Yeah.
But one thing about me, though, I don't want to stop YouTube. I want to be, like, at that Drake level and still doing it, you know?
Huh.
Yeah, I feel like
it's... But do you think it kind of is too personal sometimes? Because you have to share a lot of yourself
on these platforms. Yeah, but, like, even now, like, if you watch my channel, you might think you know me, but you don't. You know, I don't show everything. It's a lot of stuff that people don't get to see that I do and see, you know? Like, I don't vlog, like, if I'm kicking it with somebody or something, I'm not going to whip out a camera, you know what I mean? It's just like...
You have a girlfriend?
Nah, I don't.
Okay.
single.
So what don't people know about you that think they know you?
I'm very, 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 very chill. I'm laid back, super laid back. In my videos, you know, you got to be entertaining.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I be a little loud and stuff like that, but I'm really chill. I'm observant, you know? I like to relax.
What's your birthday? What sign are you?
I'm a Libra.
Ah.
Yeah.
So you are chill.
Super That's duper chill.
What Libras do. They chill. Yeah,
relaxing, chilling. They're entertainers, though. There's a lot of successful Libras out there.
Yeah, yeah. So today's a rough day because all this stuff happened with, like, Nipsey Hussle.
Yeah, that messed me up.
Did you have any interaction with him? Have you guys have you guys shared words at all?
Nah, we haven't. But I listened to his music, and, like, my brother was a really, really big fan as well. And, like, yesterday is when it happened, and I had to perform. It happened, like, while I was on my way to the venue. It messed my whole mood up, you know?
So, yeah.
Yeah. So I did, like, a moment of silence and stuff like that.
During your show?
Yeah.
That was great.
Yeah, it was sad for sure. Like, yeah. It's just weird to even think that that happened, you know what I mean? Because, like, I just watched a little GQ thing that he did with Lauren London.
Yeah.
And now this happened, you know?
Right.
So sad.
What does a young rapper like you learn from a guy like him just by watching him?
I don't know, man. It's just be safe. That's what I took from it, you know? Mm. But he was like a leader, you know? He was about empowerment and giving jewels. That's the type of person I am, which makes me, like you know, kind of scared. You know, it's like, wow, that's crazy. Like, you can still be this great to the people and something can still happen to you. It's like nobody's safe. You know what I mean?
Mm.
So it just made me feel more cautious and more paranoid. I don't like to be paranoid, but you gotta be, you know?
Yeah. Scary world.
It is.
Well, DDG, what are you performing today? Because we're going to get a performance from you, right?
Yeah, I'm going to give y'all some Run It Up and some Lil Baby.
Oh, okay.
Yes,
tell
ma'am.
Us about Lil Baby a little bit, because we talked about Run It Up.
I wanted to get grown. You know what I mean?
Don't rush. Because then when you get grown, you want to get young again.
Yeah. I wanted to get grown on this song, though. You know, it's a melodic, like, intimate song. You know what I mean? Like, it's something that you would play with your girl or something like that.
Okay.
So it's like, you know, it's a vibe.
You have another song like that called Arguments, right?
Yep. It's my biggest song, actually.
Oh, my God. So the video to Arguments.
Yep.
The girl at the end gets hit by the car, which I was like, oh, my God. Why would she get hit by the car like that?
You just spoiled it. That's what? Crazy.
Wait. But then she's pregnant.
Pregnant. Yep.
Before we go to your music, like, did you come up with that? What's the symbolism behind that?
Yeah, I came up with that. It was just like, you know, it was just... The whole point of the video was, what's the point of arguing? Life is so short.
Oh.
You know what I mean? Like, you can sit here and get in this fight, but you don't really know, like, when's the last time you're going to see this person. You know what I mean? So, she ended up getting hit by a car, and she was pregnant.
That's crazy.
That's sad,
and
right?
Then it looked real. I was like, good Lord.
imagine you getting in an argument with your significant other, and then... 5 minutes later, he get hit by a car.
Right, it makes you reevaluate. Like, we should never end on a like bad note.
Yeah, you gotta go to sleep happy.
Right.
You gotta
You're performing your other lady song, Lil Baby, right? Mm-hmm. And Run It Up. So the people here, you have YouTube here, you have your managers, the label people, which are signed now. Mm-hmm. Please give it up. DDG performing live here on the Radio 103.9 Lounge. I'm Mina Saywhat. I'm gonna move out of your way.
All right.
Face down, little baby, you know how we getting down. We getting down. My friends told me, I know how you get around. When you with me, you moaning them different sounds. Listen, baby, I know that you hear it now. You wanna roll with me, riding the rolls with me, go toe to toe with me. I call you over and we going at it. I'm taking your soul with me. You keep on calling and blowing my phone, cause I got some holes in me.
Yeah.
Little baby need to listen. I ain't talking about when Drake featured little baby meeting all my women. Wrestled up while we tussling. Got the back scratches in the picture. Type of shit where we both come like we bought tickets for admission. Lil baby, my addiction, yeah. Lil baby, need to listen. I ain't talking about when Drake featured Lil baby, meeting all my women. Wrestled up while we tussling. Got the back scratches in the picture. Type of shit where we both come like we bought tickets for admission. Lil baby, my addiction, yeah. You caught my attention. Now we picking up the slack. Bend down, look back. Go ahead, throw it back.
gave me looking like a stack. Big moans when I crack. You open up, I attack. Made me wanna throw some racks, yeah. You get it soaked, that's no issue. And knowingly how I slide in, it's so smooth, uncontrollably. Already knowing she's showing me what I be missing emotionally. When I'm on tour, all these girls wanna go with me. Acting all socially, vocally. Now all these bots keep on posting me globally. Then she start yelling and cursing ferociously. Little baby need to listen. I ain't talking about when Drake featured little baby meeting all my women. Wrestled up while we tussling, got the back scratches in the pigeon. Type of shit where we both come like we bought tickets for admission. Little baby, my addiction, yeah. Little baby, need to listen. I ain't talking about when Drake featured little baby meeting all my women. Wrestled up while we tussling, got the back scratches in the pigeon. Type of shit where we both come like we bought tickets for admission. Little baby, my addiction, yeah.
Let's run it up. Whoa, 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 hey.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Little baby gon' run it up, 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 run it up. Shawty gon' fuck it up, 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 fuck it up. She gon' shake it fast, she gon' drop it low. She gon' shake it fast, she gon' drop it low. Little baby gon' run it up, 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 run it up. You cannot tell her shit, she's trying to get rich. In the club too thick, everybody wanna hit. She when I let them hit gold, these niggas broken sheet, no. She fuck with me on the low, DDG finna blow, yeah. Throw that ass so quick, she my number one pick. Baby girl too lit, but these niggas ain't shit. Shawty cute, just face it, eyeballer, no LASIK. Open up, let me taste it, I ain't tryna be basic. She ain't really with the games, no play for the lames. Smart girl got brains, and she ballin' no James. Shawty bad, she got a whole lot of ass in her bag. Shawty finessing the cash, yeah. Yeah, baby gon' run it up, 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 run it up. Shawty gon' fuck it up, 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 fuck it up. She gon' shake it fast, she gon' drop it low. She gon' shake it fast, she gon' drop it low. Little baby gon' run it up, 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 run it up.
Yeah, 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 yeah. We live, ain't we? Appreciate y'all tuning in to the live stream, man. Go check out my new EP, Sorry for the Hold Up. Shout out Radio 103.9.